I feel like it'd be a massive train wreck if we didn't talk about guitar gear a bit.
Yeah, absolutely.
I feel like we'd get crucified in the comments. but how do you approach your mindset when it comes to gear? Like, what's going through your mind for picking a rig?
Well, we were talking about it with Mimi.
Yeah.
And she was saying how she got one of her first strats. I think her mom got her, but it just didn't ever play well.
Yeah.
You know, so that's the whole thing, is finding a strat that plays well is a little bit harder than.
Yeah.
Than you imagine.
That's right, yeah.
So it's kind of per guitar for me. I'm like, why does this guitar feel great, but this one doesn't? Mm. You know, and it has a lot to do with everything. The way the pickups are set up, the way the neck is set up, the action. Of course, what pedals you're running through and what amps you're running through. Now, personally, I did figure out a long time ago that I'm more of a clean tone cat. But if I'm running two dry pedals, I got them set, one clean and one cleaner. Okay. So, it's just sounds better. I can hear my hands.
Ah, yeah, yeah.
You know,
but when you set up this rig today with the Cream Dream Strat and the, I think it was going for a Fender Twin.
Yeah, it's
a
Twin.
But it was I've never really played through such a clean amp, but it made me approach guitar in such a different way. And
yeah.
I was like, you opened my eyes to something like
it
that.
It sounded
yeah.
right, didn't it?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Honestly, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, also my dad said, he said he could take over the world with a Twin and a Tube Screamer.
That's not the best quote ever. Yeah, that's crazy.
But those Twins are so damn loud.
Oh, but yeah. We actually got told to turn down, didn't we?
They would kind of ran everybody out there that was like,
yeah.
When I play rhythm guitar, I'll have all my pedals set, and then I'll like play my rhythm on like 7.5 or 8, and then when I go to my lead, then I go like awesome. That. Like my dad, he'll turn everything up, and then he'll come back a little bit to 9 for his leads.
Okay.
He says it sounds better than to have it opened all the way.
Oh, really?
He doesn't do that. He always brings it back a little bit. For whatever reason. just to let you know that.
That's interesting.
Pick, I hold the pick like Stevie did, you know.
Wait, oh, I need to ask you about this, because yeah. I recently did a video about this. I don't know if I got it crazy wrong or not, but if you can come spoil that a second.
Yeah.
So most people, if I'm thinking correctly, they'd hold it with the sharp bit. Yeah. Did Stevie turn it like yeah. that?
Play the butt end of it.
Yeah, okay. So for some reason, I've always done that naturally.
Oh, no kidding. Yeah, yeah.
But I don't know why, but I don't know if I don't, maybe it's a bad technique.
It's interesting because, let me see. So, I mean, most folks are like this, you know, and you're only getting a very, it's not a lot of, but he's with the fat end of it.
Uh-huh. Yeah. You can hear the difference.
Like that versus like this when you first started out.
Yeah.
So I don't know. It's something you get used to, yeah. honestly.
Yeah, yeah.
And once I went like that, I don't go back. You know, I do the hybrid picking as well. Most people do that, you know?
Yeah.
You get all your high E.
Yeah,
you
know,
you're just
yeah.
doing all that. When you get to your high E, you want to like hybrid pick it if you can.
See, that's something that I picked up naturally, but I don't know how. It's just
cool.
It felt intuitive to do both of those things of using
yeah,
the hybrid
picking.
Yeah,
it's interesting. And so it's just, you know, if it's one, it's either one or the other. I don't even know if it's right or wrong. It's just what it is. And it's kind of like, you know, you don't have any picks around the house and, oh, you found one pick. It's a light pick and you hate light picks.
Yeah.
Before you know it, you get it down. You're like, you know,
yeah,
I
exactly.
like the light pick, you know.
You can do more funky, like,
yeah,
trip
yeah,
or something.
All of a sudden,
yeah, yeah.
You know, so it doesn't matter what kind of get used to.
Well, the ironic thing is when I hold my pick upside down, which I always do, I get so many comments saying, why is that guy holding his pick
oh,
like that?
Oh, crazy. Yeah, I didn't know.
Yeah.
Very interesting.
I don't know why. I've never seen anyone say that about Stevie, like, why is he holding it like that? But maybe it's because they can't see closely enough or...
And I think I just saw Stevie do it from video. I just saw him, you know, I don't think I heard of any that he did that. I think I just saw it.
Right, yeah.